Hey guys, it's Shelby, otherwise known as Shelbizleee here on YouTube, and today I want to talk about how to use a fountain pen. Now I talked about these a little bit ago in my eco-friendly back to school supplies video, and I mentioned a fountain pen because every time you need to refill your ink, you don't have to throw away a whole pen. You don't even have to throw away a whole ink cartridge, and I think that that is probably the most sustainable options when it comes to writing. In this video, I want to talk about how you can take apart a fountain pen, how you can refill the piston that's within it. I'm going to show you how I write with it, and then we'll show you how to reassemble it too, of course. Now this pen specifically is made of bamboo. It's from a company called Dryden, and they make really, really nice pens, very good quality. I am always preaching quality over quantity to you guys. If you purchase one really good quality pen, like the one we have here from Dryden, then you don't have to purchase multiple pens throughout your time, and you'll be sure to keep up with it because it was better quality and you had to pay a little bit more than, you know, 10 cents down at the store for a plastic pen. It's also gonna be more sustainable because it is made from bamboo and not from plastic, which we learned recently comes from petroleum. And we all know petroleum is a very environmentally harmful process to extract it from the earth, and also to make plastic products emits a lot of greenhouse gases and toxins that we want to avoid. So when your pen is made from bamboo, like the one we have here, this is going to be a much more sustainable option. And then of course on top of that, you have the fact that it is refillable. I'm gonna leave a link to this pen specifically and also to the website of Dryden, which that's who makes this pen. They make a lot of other pens out of a lot of other types of wood, but they make different fountain pens, and you can even personalize them with your name and really cool stuff like that. I know it might be a little old school, but you can also be like the coolest kid on the block with the most badass pen. And if that's something you're interested in, stay tuned. So as you can tell just by getting started, this is a really high quality pen that has a very nice weight to it, and the way it grips is very unique, and I really, really appreciate that. Also, as you can see here, this is a medium size nib. That's what you call the head of a fountain pen. And we're just gonna go ahead and get started with taking it apart. I think a lot of people are intimidated by fountain pens, but as you can see, taking it apart is super simple. You're just going to be unscrewing the converter from the head part of the pen. So what you're looking at now is the converter part of this fountain pen. It can twist up and down, and that is going to be what allows the ink to come into the cartridge and leave the cartridge. So you want to start with the cartridge rolled all the way down, and you're going to put it into your ink that way and start to roll it up. This is going to allow the ink to come into the cartridge, which is what we want for filling it up for our first use. As you can see, I'm twisting it and the ink is being sucked up into the cartridge, and once it's full, that's really all there is to it. You want to move the ink aside and then reassemble the pen the exact same way we disassembled it. Attach the cartridge to the head or the nib, and then attach that to the main part, like the handle, screw it on, and it is as simple as that. The only other thing you're going to want to do before you use it is leave it upside down vertically for a few minutes so that the ink can move from the cartridge to the nib. Once your fountain pen is ready to use, I think you'll be very impressed at how smooth and elegant this ink flows from the cartridge to your nib. It's definitely something that was very different for me, but you can get very detailed with it and it looks very nice. Apart from just the pens, Dryden sets come with a very nice bamboo case that looks like this. You can open it up and it looks great for your office or to give as a gift. And last but not least, something really important to mention is that Dryden offers a lifetime money-back guarantee on their pens, so you know that they're going to be high quality. Alrighty guys, well that is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I am so excited to have this fountain pen. I really enjoy it because you can actually use it without the lid. You can hold it like this if your hand is smaller. And if your hand is larger, putting this on for some reason just makes it so much nicer. This is how I like to use it. It's also much heavier at this end. Makes it easier for me to maneuver for some reason. I just love this pen so much. Like I said, it's heavier, so you know it's really good quality. Dryden makes really good pens. When I was younger, this was something I didn't find a lot of value in, a pen like this, and now I'm so excited to have one. I'm kind of nerding out about it. Like I said in the beginning, I will leave a link to Dryden's website where you can get personalized pens, and I will leave a direct link to this one where I got it from. I really hope you found this video helpful and that you will consider getting yourself one of these because of how much more of a sustainable option it is. Always remember quality over quantity, and remember, until next time, create the piece.